COVID illness is fortunately mild in 99% of cases, and only in those 1% of cases the disease is serious, causing life-threatening complications. Although lungs, along with its oxygen scarcity, is making headlines, there is one dreaded complication we doctors are witnessing in some patients. That is, my friends, the widespread blood clot forming in organs, leading to fatal multi-organ failure and death. What are these blood clots? What causes them? And what is the treatment? Let's see in this video. I will also be telling you if there are any ways to prevent these blood clots from happening. Hello and welcome. This is Dr. Arun Naik, a neurosurgeon and a health blogger. I work in a very large tertiary care hospital at Bangalore, which is now a dedicated COVID hospital. And I am involved in the neurological care of these patients, especially those patients with blood clot in their brains. If you are new to the channel, please consider subscribing to DocLogs. As COVID-19 traversed the continents, it was clear that non-respiratory issues were actually killing a significant number of patients compared to respiratory issues. As reports of increased blood clot formation leading to widespread brain strokes and heart attacks came to picture, the medical community has come to terms with this dreaded consequence and has taken preventive action in all moderate to severe COVID cases and has put them on those preventive anti-clotting medications as a rule. We'll tell you the basics of blood clotting in our body. Friends, when you are injured, normally blood clots help stop that bleeding from that wound. When a blood vessel is injured, it produces certain proteins that attract platelets or blood cells helping blood clot. These platelets cause a clump to form a clot that plugs the injury and stops the bleeding. However, sometimes blood clots form in the absence of an injury due to various reasons. This is potentially dangerous because the clot can restrict the flow of blood within your blood vessels. If it happens in a brain artery, it causes a brain stroke. If it happens in the heart, it causes a heart attack. Blood clots with COVID-19 have most often seen in people who have been hospitalized with the disease. 1/3 of patients admitted in the ICU due to severe COVID-19 experienced complications of these blood clots. Now, how does COVID-19 cause blood clots? It's still unclear why blood clots develop in people with COVID-19. However, there are some new insights into the mechanism. Number one, endothelial cells that line the arteries express ACE2 receptors, which are the gateways for this coronavirus to enter our cells. Due to this, the virus could directly invade and damage the endothelial cells, triggering our body's clotting mechanism. Number two, damage to the tissues around the endothelial cells due to COVID infection or our body's immune response to COVID could cause increased clotting. Number three, an increase in inflammatory molecules that our immune system produces in response to viral infection could themselves activate this clotting. Lastly, number four, the platelets of people with COVID-19 were found to be hyperactive themselves, having increased activation and aggregation leading to clotting. So, out of these four factors, any one or a combination of these could trigger blood clots in a given patient. Now, who are at risk for blood clots? Number one, COVID patients who were sick from the illness and were lying down and were not walking are at the highest risk for stagnation of blood in their legs and can cause blood clots, or those patients who were hospitalized are also at high risk. Number two, patients with heart disease are prone for these clotting issues. Number three, obese individuals have high risk of developing blood clots in their legs and lungs. Number four, cancer patients on medications can have increased blood clotting. Number five, patients with blood clotting disorders can have clot formation. Now, where all blood clots can happen? Practically every organ in the body can have clotting problems, but a few situations are grave and mostly the reason for death. Number one, stroke. A favorite site for blood clot attack is brain, because brain gets 20% of blood from the heart. When a blood clot blocks a brain artery, it causes a brain stroke. Now, it depends on which artery of the brain is blocked. Some may not give much of an issue. Some may be life-threatening, causing paralysis, blindness, breathing difficulty, and memory loss. In some patients, a clot temporarily reduces the blood flow to cause a transient ischemic attack or a mini stroke, which is not life-threatening and always recovers. Number two, lungs. We call it a pulmonary embolism. A pulmonary embolism happens when a blood clot travels to lungs and blocks the flow of blood. This can decrease oxygen levels and damage the lung tissue, causing immediate death. Number three, heart. A heart attack happens when blood flow to the heart tissue is cut off. This can be fatal depending on how much of the heart muscle is damaged. Then, limbs. One of my COVID patients had his leg artery blocked due to blood clot, and his ankle had to be amputated to save his life. Rarely, the gut or kidney may get affected. Now, how to identify blood clot formation? Number one, sudden shortness of breath. Reason is a possible pulmonary embolism, as I just said. Number two, any new swelling, tenderness, pain, or discoloration in the arms or legs, especially calves. Number three, facial drooping, speech arrest, or weakness of one arm or leg suggest that one has a brain stroke. Number four, sudden chest pain or pain radiating to the neck, arms, jaw, or back suggests a heart attack. Seek attention immediately if there is associated sweating. Now, how to treat blood clots? People who have blood clots are often treated with a medication called a blood thinner, which reduces clotting in our body. Blood thinners can help prevent existing clots from getting bigger and keep new clots from forming. Initially, we treat these blood clots in the hospital using high-strength blood thinner injections. After the cool-off period, we shift to oral tablets, which need to be taken for many months and sometimes lifelong, depending upon the condition and the site of block. Older blood thinner tablets needed regular blood tests to know if they're working optimally every month. And also, there were some dietary restrictions while being on these tablets. Nowadays, we have newer blood thinner medications that are too good and don't need any monitoring tests, but they are a little expensive. Now, how to reduce your risk for blood clots? Number one, stay active. While having a COVID infection, a sedentary lifestyle can increase your blood clot risk. So make sure to get regular exercises. If you need to sit for a long time, try to take regular breaks so that you can get up and move around. Number two, lose weight if you're overweight. Shedding that excess weight can help lower your risk for developing these blood clots. Number three, don't smoke. Smokers are more at risk for developing blood clots, as smoking can damage the lining of your blood vessels and cause blood clots. Number four, drink a lot of water, especially during COVID illness, as dehydration causes a type of blood clot in the brain called cerebral venous thrombosis. I always tell my patients to drink at least 2 liters of water during day. Now, what about those reports of blood clot formation happening after COVID-19 vaccination? But these incidents have been extremely rare, and we shouldn't miss our doses just for the fear of blood clots. Incidence of blood clots after a vaccine is very, very rare, and that way any injection can cause blood clots for some reason. Friends, these reports of blood clots may not be related to vaccination, as blood clots happen without vaccines also in the community. As of now, we have only one weapon against this virus. So go and get your vaccine and safeguard your family and society. With that, friends, we have come to the end of this video. Thanks for watching and hope you found this video helpful. If you liked it, give me a big thumbs up. Share this video with all your social media circles so that it will benefit all. If you're new here, please consider subscribing to DocLogs. Hit that bell icon to get instant notifications of my new videos. I'll be back with another equally interesting DocLog very soon. Till then, feel awesome, live awesome, and take good care of your health. And yes, get your vaccines at the earliest.